reach the branches that I need to reach to climb the trees you get to climb when you're grown up.
And when I grow up, I will be smart enough to answer all the questions that you need to know the answers to before you're grown up.
And when I grow up, I will eat sweets every day. On the way to work and I will go to bed late every night.
And I will wake up when the sun comes up and I will watch cartoons until my eyes go square. And I won't care 'cause I'll be all grown up when I grow up.
when I grow up. I will be tall enough to reach the branches that I need to reach to climb the trees you get to climb when you're grown up.
And when I grow up, I will be smart enough to answer all the questions that you need to know the answers to before you're grown up.
And when I grow up, I will eat sweets every day. On the way to work, and I will go to bed late every night.
And I will wake up when the sun comes up, and I will watch cartoons until my eyes go square, and I won't care, 'cause I'll be all grown up when I grow up.
Purple and blue. I can sing a rainbow, see the clouds.
Okay, we are actually going to sing all the four songs without the rest of the nursery. I know yesterday we had everybody with us. Today we're going to do it with just you guys singing because you sang it so beautifully yesterday. Are we ready to sing Humpty Dumpty next? You ready?
Yeah.
Nice and loud. One, two, three.
Humpty Dumpty sat on a wall. Humpty Dumpty had a big fall. All the king's horses and all the king's men couldn't get Humpty together again.
Right, we're ready for Twinkle Twinkle now. I'm going to count you down to three. One, two, three.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are. Up above the world so high, like a diamond in the sky. Twinkle, twinkle, little star. How I wonder what you are.
Now it's going to be, we are leaving Fernhill Nursery. We'll fix your hat before you do your song. Here we are.
Okay.
Here we go.
Right. You ready? We are leaving Fernhill Nursery. Yes, we are. We are. We are leaving Fernhill Nursery. Yes, we are. We are. We are leaving Fernhill Nursery.
Them back again to this area, that's it, and we're all going to walk in and you'll see all of your friends sitting on the benches. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Right. Yeah. Now come quick, next wee one, Iva, here, and follow us in. Next, stay in your line and then come in, that's great.
Boys and girls, that was absolutely fantastic. I think we should give them a big round of applause. What do you think? Well done. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Mark Donnelly. I'm the head teacher of Fernhill School, and it's my great privilege to welcome you to our nursery graduation today. Well, you know what they say, never work with animals and children, but when it's your job and you have to work with the children, they will just do what they have to do and we will follow their lead. But that was so much fun, really well done. So I'm in the very privileged position now to hand you over to the nursery staff. We have a fantastic nursery staff who work so hard with our children. They look after them, they care for them, and most importantly, they love them. And leading that staff is Mrs. Leslie Ann Sheldon, our nursery manager.
Hi. On behalf of myself and the staff, I would like to welcome you all to the nursery graduation. The last 15 months has been a trying time for everyone, especially for the parents who had to do homeschooling, which you did a marvellous job, and I thank you all and well done. Unfortunately, we're unable to have you here in person today, but current technology has helped us to overcome this. Before I introduce you to the staff, I would like to thank all our little stars over here who are dressed in their graduation gowns. It was a note, it is not, sorry, if it was not for them, we would not be here today. We have not only taught these children, but they have taught us many things, like how to floss and to play the game of the lava game. So a big thanks to you guys, thank you. I would now like to introduce you to the nursery team, so far and beyond, to ensure that the children in their care reach their full potential, and this also gives me the opportunity to thank them all for their hard work throughout the year. So a big thank you to my staff, thank you. Room 1 staff are Miss Yvonne and Miss Laura, and Mr. Charlie, who has just finished his teaching training and has been working within their room for the last few weeks, and I'm sure he will be sadly missed when he leaves tomorrow. My fellow co-worker, Miss Karen, and lastly I'm going to hand over to Missy Gallagher, who supports me and manages the nursery. And I would just want to say thank you, Mrs. Gallagher. So everyone, Mrs. Gallagher.
Thank you, Mrs. Sheldon. Thank you. And I have to say that the direction of support comes more from the nursery team to me than from me to the nursery team. And it's my pleasure to be here today to see the boys and girls graduating from nursery. And I'm going to ask you to come on to the stage one at a time so that all your mums and dads and family and friends who are watching from home can see you enter that stage in nursery for the last time. And I'm almost crying saying that, but you're all going off to primary one and that's wonderful. When I call your name, I'd like you to walk to your seat, and I'm hoping you can remember where that is. Adam Zazie. Well done, Adam. Isla Ramsey. Jacob Bumagedia. Alexia Kirdejeva. Jude O'Donnell. Darcy Kirkham. Natanya Osayama and Osa David. Noah Jagodinsky. And Salsabil Munir. Perfect. Wow, that is amazing. You remembered everything there to get into your right seats. Now, at the beginning, before we started our live performance today, you were treated to a little ensemble of Fernhill memories, and it was played out to the tune of When I Grow Up from the musical Matilda. The children are now going to tell you what they would actually like to be when they grow up. And I'm going to ask them one at a time to stand up, to show their picture, and tell us all what they would like to be when they grow up. Are we ready?
Yeah,
good. Adam, let's hear what you're going to be. Tell everybody, nice and loud.
Doctor.
A doctor. Well done, Adam. Isla. A teacher. And will you come to Fernhill School and be a teacher? Oh, fantastic. So you can just stay at Fernhill School all the way through, and then when you leave, go to university and come back again. That would be great. We'll see you for the rest of your life. That would be lovely. Jacob, what are you going to be? A footballer. And what's your favourite team, Jacob? Who are you going to play football for?
Scotland.
Oh, Scotland. Well, we really need your help, so get practising. We've got a big game tomorrow. Do you think you could play in that? Alexia, what are you going to be?
A doctor of animals.
A doctor of animals, and that doesn't surprise me because you are so kind with animals and everything to do with nature. Wonderful. Jude, what are you going to be?
A joiner.
A joiner, and you're going to come and build Mrs. Gallagher a house, aren't you? Fantastic. What about you, Darcy?
An artist.
An artist, and we look forward to seeing your paintings in a fancy exhibition one day, I think. Natanya, what are you going to be? Oops. Nice and loud so that everyone can hear you.
A ballerina princess.
And you're already a princess, aren't you? So you're just going to become a bigger princess when you're older. Noah, what are you going to be?
A builder.
A builder. And that won't surprise anyone in this room because Noah is always building things for us. And Salsabil, what are you going to be? A doctor and a fairy doctor. And I think you'll be a great fairy doctor because I have seen you playing doctors in nursery and you're the most authentic doctor that I know. Pardon?
Doctor's stuff.
We've got lots of doctor's things in the nursery, haven't we? So that is fantastic. All of these children with great ambition and we have great expectation for all of them. And I would like to take this opportunity just to thank you for partnering with us in building and developing this aspiration and ambition that we have in the room with us today. The children are a credit to you, and it's our privilege and pleasure that you have trusted us with their care and support for the last few years. And it's been a great honour to oblige you in looking after your children. This year, as Mrs. Sheldon said, has been a difficult year for everyone. However, despite the difficulties of coronavirus and the restrictions that that has placed upon us, we have still managed to grow the nursery. We have enrolled 10 new children and settled them within the restrictions of coronavirus. And that's a 50% increase in our role, so that was no mean feat. We also have had Mrs. Sheldon, who is hiding her light behind a bushel, in fact, throughout the year, has continued to attend university, working towards her degree in early years. And that's something, again, that hasn't been easy while managing all of the restrictions and the changes and modifications that we've had to make. We're also delighted to tell you that we have two new members of staff joining us in August. They will be joining us, very experienced practitioners who are also qualified to degree level in early years, and they are going to be a huge asset to Fernhill School Nursery. Our improvement agenda for next year is as ambitious as it's always been, and we're looking to really partner with you, our parents, in executing that improvement plan. So don't be surprised if we come phoning you or tapping at your door or whatever we're allowed to do next year, looking for your support and your guidance in our improvement agenda, because it's your children that we look after and it's important that you are in agreement with the things that we are doing. So thank you so much for being our partners and for being wonderfully supportive of everything that we've had to do. And I know that not all of it you have been in full agreement with, but you have accepted that it was what we had to do, and we thank you for that. And now it's time to give these boys and girls their certificates of graduation. And that means you're all grown up now, you're about to graduate from nursery and move on to primary school. And that's very exciting, isn't it? Yes, you've got to get all the way to school. You've got a big holiday in front of you, and then we're going to school. So I'm going to call you out. I'm going to ask the girls to, if they would come over, and they're going to give you your certificates, and I'm going to call you one at a time. And I'm going to start with the room two children. And when I call your name, you're going to come down to the front, and then your teacher is going to give you your graduation certificate, and then we will all give them a big clap. Once you've got your certificate, you're going to just come back onto your seat and we'll call the next person, okay? So the first person I'm going to call up is Adam. Now Adam is our weather expert in nursery and he loves to give us the weather of the day. And he is fantastic at keeping everyone on track with the nursery routine. So Adam, we wish you well moving on to primary one. Well done, Adam. Next up is Isla. Isla is our very own resident GI Jane. On outdoor trips to the meadows, you will find her climbing, swimming almost, getting caught in quicksand at one point and almost bringing Mrs. Gallagher into the quicksand with her. And she has a fantastic sense of humour and a great imagination. Isla is going to be a great asset to her primary one class. Well done, Isla. Going to call Jakob, and Jakob has only been with us for a short while, but in that short time he has made great friends, and you will often find Jakob reading a story because he actually can already read, which is quite amazing for someone his age. He loves to build Lego structures and he has just been a great addition to our nursery class. Well done, Jakob, and good luck in primary one. Next up, we have Alexia. Alexia is our nature lover. She loves everything about nature and regularly brings us flowers and different things from the meadows, but she would only ever bring something if it has fallen off of the plant. She never picks a flower, only brings you things that have already fallen off, and that's testament to her love of nature. She is so friendly and she is very artistic and loves nothing more than to create things for the nursery. And Alexia, you're going to be great in primary one. Good luck. Next up, we have Jude. Now, Jude is our have a go hero. He will try anything, and again, down in the secret garden, you'll often see him climbing, jumping from logs, and just doing lots of things that are full of adventure. Jude has also tried to teach the ladies how to floss, but so far, they haven't managed it. But I wonder, Jude, could you give us a little floss to see if we can pick it up? Oh, wow, that is fantastic, Jude. Well done, and you are going to be a star in primary one. Next up, we have Darcy. Now, Darcy is a quiet and gentle girl who has blossomed since coming to Fernhill School. She is the best friend you could ever wish for. She will often play things that she doesn't even want to play just because somebody else needs a friend, and that is quite a skill to have, Darcy. Darcy can also often be found helping other children with making things or doing things, getting dressed, doing anything that they need. And if you ever need a partner, Darcy is the person to go to. She will never let you down. Darcy, you're going to be a great asset in primary one. Good luck. Olivia's not with us today, but it would be remiss not to mention her because Olivia has been with us since she was 2 years old, and she has grown from a tiny little girl, a baby, who said very little, to a very bubbly, bright girl full of chat and stories. Olivia always has a smile and she's a very considerate girl, and it's a shame she can't be with us today. But Olivia, if mums or dads are watching, or if you watch it back, we wish you every success in primary one. So a big clap for Olivia. And now we'll move on to room one, who who have sat very, very patiently. You've done very well, boys and girls, and I've only got a few more minutes to keep you there, okay? So we're going to come now to Natanya. Natanya loves to tell stories to other children, sometimes with a book, other times just from her own imagination. And you can often find her organising books, stories and games for other children. And that can be either inside the nursery or outside, because her imagination extends beyond the walls of the nursery. Natanya, we look forward to you going to Primary 1 and being a great success. Next up, we have Noah. Now, Noah is a brave boy. And again, he exercises lots of excitement and risk-taking when we're out in the meadows. Noah actually knows every inch of the meadows. When we go to Fernbury Meadows, he tells us where to go and what we will find there. He knows every tree, he knows every stream, every branch. He also loves to build things. He will build anything. He loves anything that moves, anything to do with science, and he has just got that inquisitive mind that's going to take him far in primary school. Noah, good luck. We wish you well. And Salsabil, up you come, Salsabil. Salsabil is the most convincing doctor I've ever seen at the age of five. If you ever have the joy of watching Salsabil play doctors, you actually would believe you were in the emergency room or in your local GP surgery. She knows the terminology, she knows what to do with all the equipment, and she has a bedside manner that is second to none that I have ever seen in a real doctor. And when she told us before that she wanted to be a doctor, it was of no surprise to me, because I would have said, if I had to guess what she was going to be, I would have guessed a doctor. So Salsabil, good luck in Primary 1, and I hope to see you as a doctor one day. And the other girl in Room 1 who is not here is Lucy. She's on holiday and can't be with us. Again, Lucy joined as a very shy and quiet two-year-old some 3 years ago, and since then has developed into a confident young girl, ready to meet the challenges of Primary 1. Lucy is a very caring and helpful girl, and even in the little video that you saw, there's an image of her putting on Francesco's shoe, and that really typifies Lucy, because she'll often be found doing things to help the younger children in her room. And Lucy, you're going to be a great success too in Primary 1, and we wish you lots and lots of luck. Good luck. So boys and girls, that's you graduated. And now Mrs. Dempsey is going to read you a few words to see you on your way.
Good morning. Great expectations. It's time to say goodbye. Our year has come to an end. We've made some cherished memories with all our nursery friends. We've watched each other learn and grow and change from day to day. We hope that all the things we've done will help us along the way. So it's with a happy memories that we all go out the door with great hope and expectations for what next year has in store. And well done, everybody. A big round of applause for the children.
We said earlier that we have had the pleasure of welcoming Mr. Murray into the nursery, and Mr. Murray has qualified as a primary teacher, and as part of his probation has carried out this placement in nursery, and he's absolutely been a fantastic help to us. And I think, Mr. Murray, you're maybe going to say a few words just to summarise your experience.
Well, so a little background. I joined Fernhill in Primary 7, and I had such a good time that I asked if I could stay on until the end of term. Little did I realise that I was going to be sent down to the nursery, and little did the staff realise they were going to have another child in room one. So, but I've had an unbelievable time. It's been an incredible experience. I had another steep learning curve involved, but the staff have all been absolutely excellent, and they work incredibly hard. So they can be proud of their efforts in a very difficult year, and it's just been great. It's been excellent. Thank you very much.
And it's been absolutely great to have Charlie. Oftentimes when we go into the room or out into the garden, you will see Mr. Murray participating in the games with the boys and girls on the pirate ship, and he doesn't get any away from it, because the children force him to take part. I think they just feel that he is also another one of their friends, which is lovely, a great accolade to him. Before the children sing us out today, I would like to ask Mr. Donnelly to come and just say a few closing words, and then the children will process back outside to sing their songs again. Thank you.
Boys and girls, you were amazing, and you know, you look so grown up. I remember when I came to the nursery to do some music with you, you just looked like little children, but now you're in your gowns and your hats, and you just look so grown up, all ready for primary one. And I am certain, listening to all of these jobs and occupations that you want to do when you grow up, that this won't be the last time we see you in gowns and hats. So very, very well done. I'm going to go and say a few words now to your mums and dads and your families and friends who might be watching us on television or from their computers at their work.
Since joining Fernhill School as head teacher a couple of years ago, I have had the very great pleasure of spending an hour a week with the children in the nursery doing some music with them. COVID obviously interrupted that process, but whilst it wasn't possible to physically be with them, I have enjoyed watching them playing in the garden and arriving at school in the morning or leaving in the evening, and always with the happiest smile on their faces. It's been our pleasure to work in partnership with you to ensure the children have the best possible experience. So as we send them off to the next stage of their educational journey, I'd like to thank Mrs. Gallagher, who is our head of early years, and Mrs. Sheldon, our nursery manager, and all of the amazing staff you've heard from today and who have supported the children so brilliantly these past couple of difficult years. Thank you for helping to shape their character and the person they are growing into. Boys and girls, I hope you all have a wonderful summer. And for those of you who are going to be joining us in Fernhill School in Primary 1, we'll see you very soon. And for the rest of you, we will miss you very much. And we hope that you are happy in your new school. And we send you off with all of our love, lots of love, and big hugs. So thank you very much. And I think you're going to sing for us again. Is that right?
Yes, we're going outside again to sing.
Shall we get ready to go out?
So if we can go, Salsabil, from you, if you go down that step and then walk right outside where you were before. So you just follow Salsabil that way, Natanya, will you? Excellent. And then Darcy, if you come, just Noah, you need to go too. We need your voice. We definitely need your voice. I could hear your voice out here. Perfect. And then Darcy, you're going to come next. And then Jude, just follow on. Alexia, just watch your feet pick. And Jakob. Isla. And Adam. You're going to go all the way. Hi, that's us. And then all our friends. Sit back, stand back a little bit, and all of these boys and girls will sit on the mat.
Perfect. You sit down, Gabriel. All our friends going to sing with us for our graduation. All four
together. Sit down.
Oh, careful, boys. Mind the mic.
Answers to
before you're grown up.
And when I grow up, I will eat sweets every day. On the way to work, and I will go to bed late every night. And I will wake up when the sun comes up, and I will watch cartoons until my eyes go square. And I won't care, 'cause I'll be all grown up when I grow up. Cartoons until my eyes go square.